Welcome to the studio of NIOS. Myself, Dr. Anjali Shoki, Assistant Professor, University School of Education, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University. Today we are going to discuss about motivation, its characteristics and types. When you come from your school, you feel hungry and want to eat something. You want to eat because there is a force which compels you to have the food. Likewise, if a question is asked, why do you want to join a college? The answer can be given in different ways, like you want to learn, you need a degree to get a good job, you may want to join college to have lot of friends. This basic question is why of behavior, or what are the factors which compels us to do certain activities, makes us to study the psychological processes, which is known as motivation. Motivation refers to the factors which moves or activates the persons. We infer the presence of motivation when we see that people work towards certain goals. For example, we might observe that a student works hard for almost every task that comes to him or her. From this, we can infer that person has motive to achieve. All human behavior appears to arise in response to some form of internal, that is the physiological, or the external, that is the environmental stimulation. The behaviors, however, are not random. They often involve some purpose or goal. Thus, we can say that motivation is the process of activating, maintaining and directing behavior towards a particular goal. There are many definitions which are given by the psychologist. According to B.F. Skinner, motivation in school learning involves arousing, persisting, sustaining and directing desirable behavior. According to Maslow, motivation is constant, never-ending, fluctuating and complex. It is almost universal characteristics of every organism's state of affairs. To conclude, we can say that motivation is regarded as something which prompts, compels and energizes an individual to act or behave in a particular manner at a particular time for attaining some specific goal or purpose. But what exactly is responsible for the motivation of an individual? What are the real activating forces that push and pull an individual to move or act for achieving a specific goal? Psychologists have tried to provide the answer by identifying these activating forces such as needs, drives, and motives. So, to explain the meaning of motivation, we need to understand that what are needs, what are drives, and what are motives. First of all, we'll discuss about what are needs. Needs are general wants or desires. Every human being has to strive for the satisfaction of his or her basic needs if he has to maintain, improve, or fulfill himself or herself in the world. There are a number of different needs. Psychologists have divided the human needs into two broad categories. Number one, primary or physiological needs. Second one is secondary or socio-psychological needs. All our bodily needs comes under this category. We all need oxygen, water and food, because these all are fundamental for our survival. In the chain of our survival, the other needs such as rest when tired, action when rested, regular elimination of waste products from the body, sleep after doing work, protection from threats like hazards of weather, wild animals, etc. Next is secondary or socio-psychological needs. These needs are unique to human beings and are acquired through social learning. These needs drive the individuals towards special kinds of behavior. Since these needs are learned, their strength differs greatly from one individual to another. Some of the important socio-psychological needs are need for freedom or for gaining independence, need for security, need for company, need for love and affection, need to achieve, need for recognition or social approval, need for self-expression or self-actualization. Next is the drives. The needs gives rise to drives. Drives are defined as an aroused awareness, tendency, or a state of heightened tension that sets off reactions in an individual and sustains them for increased activity level. The strength of a drive depends upon the strength of the stimuli generated by the related need. Drives are also influenced and guided by the incentives like praise, appreciation, rewards, bonus, fulfillment of one's need and achievement are the examples of incentives. All incentives works as reinforcing agent as they add more force to a drive. Drives are generally affected and directed by the incentives. Next is the motives. The term motive refers to goal-directed behavior and energizing conditions within the organism that drives the behavior. It works as a basic activating force behind a particular behavior. Motive is an inclination or impulsion to action plus some degree of orientation or direction. Motives directs the activity of the individual towards person's goal. It is an inner state of mind or an aroused feeling generated through basic needs or drives which compel an individual to respond by creating a kind of tension or urge to act. It may be considered to be a learned response. Now, motivation. We have discussed about the need, drives. Now, the next one is the motivation. What is motivation? How we define motivation? Motivation is an inner feeling which energizes a person to work more. The emotions or desires of a person prompts them for doing a particular work. A person moves to fulfill his unsatisfied needs by conditioning his energies. There are some dormant energies in a person which are activated by channelizing them into the actions. Motivation is a never-ending process. Man is a social animal and has countless wants which encourages him to work. And these wants cannot be satisfied at one time. It is an never-ending process. Therefore, the process of motivation is also never-ending. The importance of motivation is to keep it alive and not to let it drop. It is a complex phenomena. Motivation, being an internal feeling, cannot be observed directly. And since motives themselves are dynamic, it further adds to the complexity. Motivation leads to an action that is goal-oriented. It leads to accomplishment of organizational goals and satisfaction of personal needs. Motivation is influenced by two forces: internal forces that are internal to the individual, their needs, wants, and nature. External forces are external to the individual, which may be organizational, such as management philosophy, organizational structure, and superior subordinate relationship. Motivation can be positive or it can be negative. Positive motivation offers positive incentives such as appreciation, promotion, status, and incentives. Whereas negative motivation emphasizes penalties, fines, and punishments. Motivation is a dynamic and complex process, as human behavior is highly complex and it becomes extremely difficult to understand people at work. Next is achievement motivation. Every human being desires the need for achievement or the need to attain excellence and the higher level of performance. People in whom the need for achievement is strong seeks difficult work and improves their task performance. They are future oriented, aspire for higher goals, and persist on the work they have chosen. They are task oriented and prefers to work on challenging tasks and on which performance can be evaluated in some way. Next is, what are the different types of motivation? Basically, there are two types of motivation. First one is intrinsic motivation and the extrinsic motivation. First of all, we will discuss about intrinsic motivation. It means that individuals' motivational stimuli are coming from within. It involves engaging in a behavior because it is personally rewarding, essentially performing an activity for its own sake rather than the desire for some external rewards. For example, participating in sports because the person finds the activity is enjoyable. In all these examples, the person's behavior is motivated by an internal desire. They participate in the activities for their own sake. Essentially, the behavior itself is their own reward. Our deep-rooted desires have the highest motivational power. There are some examples like acceptance, curiosity, honor, independence, order, power, social contact, social status. In all these examples, the person's behavior is motivated by an internal desire. They participate in the activities for their own sake. Essentially, the behavior itself is their own reward. Next is extrinsic motivation. Extrinsic motivation means that the individual's motivation stimuli are coming from outside. In other words, our desires to perform a task are controlled by an outside source. It occurs when we are motivated to perform a behavior or engage in an activity to earn a reward or avoid punishment. It is external in nature. The most well-known and most debated motivation is money. Some examples are studying because you want to get a good grade, cleaning your room to avoid being scolded by your parents, participating in sports to win awards, competing in a contest to win a scholarship. In all these examples, the behavior is motivated by a desire to gain a reward or avoid an adverse outcome. Next is, the next question comes in our mind, that which is best? Means either extrinsic motivation is best or the intrinsic motivation is best. While most people suggest that intrinsic motivation is best, it is not always possible in every situation. In some cases, people simply have no internal desire to engage in an activity. Excessive rewards may be problematic, but when they are used appropriately, extrinsic motivators can be useful tool. For example, extrinsic motivation can be used to get people to complete a work task or school assignment in which they have no internal interest. Researchers have arrived at three primary conclusions with regards to extrinsic rewards and their influence on the intrinsic motivation. First one is, unexpected external rewards typically do not decrease intrinsic motivation. For example, if you get a good grade on a test because you enjoy learning the subject and the teacher decides to reward you with a gift, your underlying motivation for learning about that subject will not be affected. Second one is, praise can help increase internal motivation. Researchers have found that offering praise when people do something better in comparison to others can improve intrinsic motivation. Intrinsic motivation will decrease when external rewards are given for completing a particular task. For example, if parents praise their child every time they complete a simple task, they will become less intrinsic motivated to perform that task in the future. Now, the next one is, why motivation is important? Why motivation is necessary for all the persons? The reasons are, first one is for greater efficiency. Motivation enhances the efficiency of the individuals and of the institution. When individuals are motivated, they can perform with commitment and dedication. Second one is to reduce absenteeism and labor turnover. Motivated persons may not remain absent or leave the institution. They develop a sense of belonging towards the institution and thus improve their overall performance. For the team spirit, motivation also improves the team spirit of individuals, which improves the work environment and the overall performance of the institution. Next is reduction in wastage and breakage. Motivation persons take care in reducing the wastages and breakages and thus helps in resulting higher benefits. Next is cordial relations. Motivation enables cordial and healthy relationship as it helps in reducing the disputes. It ensures sound relations between the persons and the society. Next is for promotion of innovations. Motivated persons use their initiative to find out innovative ways in the performance of their operations. Next is for the optimum use of resources. Motivation helps in leading greater involvement and lesser wastages. This leads to optimum utilization of resources, which we can say that maximum output with minimum input. Next is for the corporate image. Motivated individuals are more loyal to the institution. They work with a sense of commitment and dedication. This improves the overall performance, which enables better results for the society. This results in better relations with all the members of the society. So, we can say that motivation is very necessary for all the human beings in the society. It is required in each and every sphere of life. Thank you.